各位后港居民，各位朋友们，各位同志们，谢谢大家这样热情的支持，谢谢你。首先我要感谢在去年大选支持我的选民，你们给我信心，你们给我力量。在这一年里，我们一起推行了许多计划，这些计划就是为了要改善我们的生活。我希望，我也呼吁选民在这次的补选，把你们的神圣的一票给我，让我们有机会一起为后港打造更美好的未来。谢谢。Dear residents of Hougang, dear supporters, you guys have been amazing. Thank you so much. Thank you for your support that I can attest in this by-election. We have served the residents hard. The residents know. Thank you so much.
So no matter which platform we take, either hitting the ground hard, either rallies, either visits to the markets, we're going to make sure that we touch everyone's heart. It's been a long journey for us. We have helped the residents for the past 1 year. Through my activists, my volunteers, we have touched the hearts of many. Elderly, the children of low-income families, the younger people, the women folks. And it is time now that we also show to the residents that I am their best candidate to be the elected representative in Parliament, so that I can voice out their concerns, their fears, their hopes. And not only do that, but act on them and make a difference on the ground.
How are you going to tell the residents that you are the best candidate?
Well, they would have, a lot of them already have known that we touch them, that we help them and we deliver results onto the ground. And this time round, it's no different. I'm still going to go around. If there are problems that residents face, they can come to me and we'll still address them. It hasn't changed. It's still going to be very much what we've been doing. We're going to tell them that together we can create a vibrant and bright future for Hougang. And that's what we're going to do.
Well, you have been walking the ground ever since you were announced as a candidate. What have been some of the key issues that they have been raising to you over the last few days before nomination day?
Of course, things like cost of living continues to be an issue. Singapore grew very fast. And this is something that will happen. And I fully empathize with their problems. We also have developed initiatives and schemes and programs that help them to mitigate some of these problems. Now, what's going to happen now, of course, is that this is just about something that we can do, and there's more that I can do if I'm the elected MP. And I know that a lot of residents will also feel that way.
Well, DPM Dharman did indicate that this is a local contest. So over the next 9 days, what are you going to do to ensure that this remains a local contest?
I think it hasn't changed. The fact that this by-election is about selecting the best candidate and the best MP that can serve the long-term interests of residents. That means not only voicing out concerns, but also acting on them and delivering real results. That hasn't changed. That will still remain the concern of this campaign. So you will start to see us also tell them that, hey, we voice your concerns, but you also see the concrete things that we have done and the information is really out there. So they can judge us by not what we are going to do for these 10 days, but what have we done for the last 15 months.
Well, this has finally turned out to be a straight fight as it was thought earlier. So what are your thoughts about this being a straight fight finally?
Like I always mention, whether it's a straight fight or it's a three-corner fight or four, we're still going to pretty much focus on our strategy, our campaign. We're going to make sure that we continue to reach out to residents. It hasn't changed that. I'm still pretty much going to keep to that same focus and fight a very good fight.
Thank you very much, Desmond Choo.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot.
Can I have a few words for you?
Yes.
用中文。
好，那么朱先生这次呢，成功成为这个后港单选区的补选的候选之一。那接下来你的这个竞选策略是什么呢？
现在竞选策略跟前四五个月其实是都是一样的，还是按部就班的去拜访居民或者在菜市也好，他们的家里也好，或者去这个车站也好，都是还是一样，都是用我们的真诚去感动他们，这是不会改变的。而在这当儿呢，如果有居民需要帮忙的话，我们还是会去尽力的帮他们解决。所以 不会改变的，还是一样。
是工人党一直把后港区当成三轮堡垒，那你对于要攻破这个堡垒有多大的信心啊？
当然，这是我们也知道，这个是一个将是一场硬战，可是我们还是每一票对我们非常重要，所以我们会非常诚恳用心的去争取每一票。而我们相信呢，只要有我们的居民，我们的支持者，他们踊跃的来支持我，我觉得我们是在这场仗会打得比较漂亮一点的。
那以这个选民的年龄层来看的话，那么很多就说你是阿嬷杀手，对于这一点你有什么看法？
其实很多阿嬷都对我非常的贴心，他们也非常的照顾我，所以我也想把这份孝心回敬他们，就是说给我一个机会再孝敬老人家因为我本身有经历过失去外婆的经历，所以每位年长者对我来说都是非常重要的。其实也不只是这样，整个后港区的居民，每一位，无论你老也好，少也好，不同种族、不同宗教，都对我非常重要。而我会从这个角度来对垒这个战略。对，
好，另外一个问题是说，因为方先工人党方先，他是说他对他来讲年龄不是问题。那对于这一点，你觉不觉得说年龄在这次的竞选的时候、补选的时候，是不是你的优势，还是变成会是你的劣势呢？
当然我会看成是一个优势，因为毕竟年轻就比较多活力嘛，因为我也可以更贴心的跟那些在比较年轻的居民联系，跟他们沟通方面的就彼此了解就比较深一点，就好像比如在昨天篮球场，很快就说你这个 NBA 的怎么样啊，竞争怎么样，就在那边谈一下球的东西，所以从中呢我可以了解他们的心声，所以说那个可能是个优势何况呢在进行比较大规模的计划，当然是在你年轻那时候比较占优势啦，因为可能可以在这个区里面待久一点嘛。对。